Bodo Jens Foster, and I worked with elephants for 28 years, at first in the European zoos, and later I developed my own ideas to make an elephant project in Thailand. When I start this, everyone in the white world, European, America, or also the Asian friends say, they wait for you. 8,000-year history of elephant keeping, and they wait for, okay, I'm not a small guy, yeah, but I'm a big guy. Okay, but you know, and they say, that's not possible. How I can bring to sit somebody on an elephant, and how I can bring somebody to sit to understand. And what I want is stay with them, eyes in eyes, touch him, feel him. That's what I do in my profession. Same like this picture, you know? Of course, you know what's mean in trunk. Yeah? Because in Asia, we call this hand, you know? This is a hand. It's a hand. They touch me, they feel me, and give me a reason to do this, what I do. Today, I want to introduce you to my world of the domesticated elephants in the northern part of Thailand. My aim is to ask you for your understanding and your patience, not only during this presentation, but also regarding the future of these creatures. Elephants, at least in Asia, are regarded as some of the most sacred animals by more than 2 billion people, as they play an important role in the Hindu and the Buddhist religion. They were also regarded as an investment for more than 8,000 years. Then, since 8,000 years, they work with people together. And this is so important. The son of Shiva, yeah, is Ganesh. Yeah? And I hope you know who I am, yeah? Who this is. As time passed, the role of the domesticated elephants was constantly adapted. They worked as war elephants and as well as precision elephants, and elephants that worked in the logging industry. And the history of the working these creatures with mankind was not so successful for them, I must say. This is also a holy symbol of many nations. Today, the Prime Minister or the former Prime Minister of Bhutan will speak. Yeah? This is for the Buddhist people, is the holy symbol. But what we do now, maybe, I don't know, and I will fight for that's not possible. We lost them. Take a specific example of Thailand and you can see how difficult adaptation can be. Logging was forbidden in 1989, and within a really short period, people had to find a new ways of earning money. Tourism was the only chance they had if they wanted to keep the elephants and also their tradition. You can see on this picture, you know, that's what I do. I bring people close to an elephant. I bring them to sit and to trust in an elephant. You have to trust in it. Many people before today talk about trust, but when you stay in front of an elephant and he's bigger than you, bigger than 2 meters, bigger than 3 meters sometimes, and I say to them, hey, please, come with me. Trust with them. Trust in me, trust in the elephant. Give me the hand and trust me. Give me the trunk and trust me. This, and then, and the natural habitat. Huh? There is no tourism way. There is no road for, I don't know which one, what kind of road. Yeah, there's just only, and believe me, somewhere, I'm also there. I have to walk also in the water, yeah? Just to compare, in 1951, more than 13,000 domesticated elephants lived in Thailand. 50 years later, the number dropped below 2,600. And today, just only in Thailand, it's around Asia too. And today, maybe we have also only in Thailand, 2,800. A little bit comes more. Imagine. Elephants live up to 70 years or more, and within just one lifespan, so many simply vanished. Important to my understanding of enduring of sustainable future for elephants that even in today's fast-changing world, they have to be seen as an investment. This is so great world. We have to make investments in the future. But we have it on our door, yeah, because they are close to us. This is our investment, maybe. And then we cannot find the answer for them. How we can find the answer for all this other stuff that we hear today and all this. They are kept by either private owners, state institutions, or elephant camp owners. Different players, different approaches. As hard it may sound, money is the key element to ensure a sustainable future for these creatures, for these elephants. Let me introduce you to my own approach. I founded Elephant Special Tours in 2001 in order to integrate elephant owners and the elephants in a new project. Traditions of the people are still high and not overseen. But adaptations to the modern tourism could be possible too. But in this time, no one believed it. No one believed me that it's possible, and believe also my staff, yeah, that we can do this. You have to understand, in my company, we are three religions. Christians, Buddhists, animists. Yeah? We have seven kind of nations work together. Yeah? And sometimes you feel you stay in the world and you see the news or something like this and you feel, this is not possible to find the answer. No, in this small project, now 50 peoples, yeah, and 18 elephants stay, yeah, we show maybe it is possible. 25 years ago, I came to Thailand for the first time to learn from Thai and Karen people about elephant keeping. I sat under the elephant and I listened to him and began to understand what working with elephants means. It's not me. Yeah? Now, I want to show you, I do the same before. Yeah? And today I do this with tourists. And they never saw an elephant, maybe in a zoo. In Austria, maybe difficult because there's only one zoo, yeah? Only in Vienna. Yeah? They have elephants. Yeah? And then I bring them in the natural habitat to sit on them and to listen to them. And they have to talk. After 5 minutes, they arrived in my camp. They sit under the elephants and they have to talk to the elephants. And they say, what? I don't know what you talk. This is like today. Yeah? I don't know what they talk. Or this is not my part. They have to talk. I began to get to know the elephant soul. This way was able to create conditions that help me today to work and live with my elephants. And I mean it's really work and live with elephants, you know. This is also, sustainability means also live with and stay with and sometimes dream on. My company focuses on elephants. It supports the families to which they belong to, and it also creates circumstances that elephants can happily live with. Furthermore, tourists are carefully and calmly introduced to those animals. Explaining is an essential part of my work, of our work. We have to explain this. We have to explain something happened. In 2010, the donation-based Tong Bai Foundation was established. By doing so, we are able to give all elephants a home in which their owners still can earn money. And even so, the animals cannot work anymore. It also leads away out of a question that animal rights activists raised some time ago. For sure, I have to work with them. It's not so easy, believe me. NGOs, this is not a good word in Asia sometimes. They rightfully argued against harsh procedures of elephant training, especially the breaking of young one. It started a movement which claimed that every part of this century-old tradition should be abolished, including important religion aspects. Tong Bai Foundation has a different way. By playfully introducing young elephants to elephant training much sooner than before, those little elephants get and use the mahouts and specific commands. Therefore, the religion parts of the ceremony can be maintained while harsh procedures are not necessary anymore. Young and old, yeah, you can see.
You learn about elephants. Old and young elephants can now live together as a healthy herd in which the young ones learn from the experience of the old ones and also from us. Creating sustainable circumstances that take elephants' need for a natural environment into account can lead through rough ways. Let me give you an example from my personal concern. Elephant special tours consist of two elephant camps. One of them is located next to a small village, and the other one is located in the mountains next to a beautiful river in the natural habitat of my elephants. This camp was closed by force by the Thai government 1 month ago. They opened a case in which they argue that my elephants destroy the forest, a case which I can neither deny nor admit. So this makes me angry, believe me. I hope you can feel it, you know. This makes me so angry. I'm sorry, my English is not so good. My elephants live in a forest. This is where they eat. This is where they defecate. This is where they live day in, day out. So eating the same food as a wild elephant is good for them. It gives them natural feed. It lets them walk in their natural surroundings. And maybe this is gone now, this camp. Not me. I'll never go. A month ago, a combined police and military raid forced my elephant keepers to ride the elephants to our other camp and afterwards took the mahouts into the jail. They were released the day after, but still we have to go to the court. I noticed on midday, 9 o'clock, and I was in Germany at this time, 9 o'clock I was on the plane and take them out, for sure. I give the passport to the police, I say, take me. They are held responsible that the animals would eat bamboo in the mountains. I cannot accept this strategy of the Thai government, and even less the thinking behind this. If elephants cannot stay in the forest anymore, there can be no future for those great animals, and also no future for us, because they are work with us since 8,000 years. They are part of our religious aspects. They are part of our heart. Remember, those are some of the largest mammals in the world. Remember, they are holy to so many people. Remember, they have a long-lasting relationship living with mankind. Because of this, we have a very special responsibility to take care of them. Now our project is under fire because we want to ensure them life that regards their needs. It's not only us. In the weeks before, other elephant camps faced similar problems. As you can see, a camp that once combined tourism with the natural needs of an elephant has been closed. This shows that the wish of many animal rights activists to reintroduce domesticated elephants to the wild is simply impossible. It is a wish that does not take reality into account. Another problem arose with the necessary adaptation to new standards. Right now, a whole generation of formerly well-trained mahouts is feared simply vanished. A highly regarded job for decades now is not more than a job for the people. This makes it not only hard for elephant owners to get young boys to take care of the elephants. It might even be dangerous, as it needs specific long-trained skills that are important to control one of the most powerful animals on the planet. Requirements for a combined training system for elephants and mahouts have to be initiated by states, institutions, elephant owners, elephant camps. To keep elephants around for the next centuries, we need to help them assuring their future. This assurance does work differently in different continents. Yeah? Great singers from Africa, where they are. Yeah? Unbelievable. Yeah? And it works differently in different countries. It even works differently in different areas of one country. Problems in the north of Thailand are not the same as in the south of Thailand. What kind of answer we can develop to ensure a future for them? Depends on the natural surroundings as well as on cultural difference. We have to develop a future for them. A life in the 21st century. We have to lead them in the 21st century. Ensuring the elephant's well-being only works with people, and there are different paths and different views how to achieve this main goal. Those different paths sometimes argue strongly. But I believe from the bottom of my heart, not me, not specific institution, not certain NGOs has the right to say my way is the only one. Compromises have to be made. People have to sit on one table. They have to talk together and to have to
to be listened to. Still, do not forget, without the urge of compromises, it's not possible to embed changes. Foreign organizations that try to establish their own ideas of elephant keeping without getting local people as well as local authorities in their boat will probably fail, which makes the future for elephants even more uncertain. We have to talk about what unites us, not what separates us. We have to develop structures that on the first hand establish a useful amount of earnings right here and right now. And on the other hand, we need to invest in the future of the elephants, which mean elephant carcasses, and especially the families of elephant owners in the last 50 years of the elephant owners. In the last 50 years, elephant people had to step back as they had to adapt to the modern society much more rapidly than anyone can imagine. Let us lead them. Let us lead the elephant into this new age. Let us develop realistic economic concepts that take local difference into account. In my understanding of working with elephants, for 28 years, the most important thing is to make people proud of their work and to let them earn money. This might be possible with donations or other ways of financing. Developed programs are essential as well as investment. For example, buying a young elephant can be regarded as a form of green investment. This one elephant animal will earn money, hopefully, for the next 70 years. This is the lifespan of an elephant. Sustainability, it's a great word. Today, every one of you uses it. Creating sustainable factors for animals that live as long as a human is a specific matter. Religion, healthcare, social features, and many more factors have to be taken into the account. Everyone of them influences newborn babies, like my Jack here, for his whole lifetime. One more thing before I close. We have to fight for our animals. But the protection of elephants under human care does only work through people. And sometimes you have to be patient with people. But they do and will learn. Let us not talk about different views regarding elephant keeping. Let us talk about what unites us. If you stand next to an elephant and look him right in his eye, he will tell you the same. Buddha teach us the way of the middle is the way of wisdom. I'm not a Buddhist, but I can listen. Thanks for attention. We'll be right back.